eyes closed, bring your attention inward. Nothing to do, nothing to seek. Everything you need is already within. To begin with the sound of Om three times to bring divine attention to the self. Imagine you're becoming one with all beings. Everywhere, be happy and free from suffering, and enjoy this practice through our senses. May we acquire a strong desire for liberation from the ignorance that binds us to pain and suffering. And may we cherish no ill feelings against any being. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Let's come to standing now and begin the practice. First, let's purify the space, the ground, and all the psychic channels that reside within with a mantra for purification. If you don't know it, just listen to the sounds and think about those benefits of purification. If you know it, you may chant along. Om apavitraha pavitrava sava dashtanga topiva yaha smarit pandrikaksham sabahiya pihantrahas chihi. Release the arms now. We'll do some warm ups just to open up the body a little bit, get the blood moving. So we're going to be doing some vigorous breathing to start to aerate the lungs and to oxygenate the blood and to energize the body. So don't worry about the inhale, happens automatically through the pressure, just the exhale of throwing the belly button against the spine. Right, so let's begin, but first just head rolls, just breathe normally. to make the circles as large as possible. Shoulders down away from the ears, always allowing for the easiest passage possible for the breath. And then switch direction of rotation. And now we're going to swing the arms back and forth. Try to get the arms behind the ears. Do the movements with enthusiasm. Now arms across the chest. Throw the arms back. As you exhale, alternate the cross each time. Release. Next one is called breath of joy. First three moves done on an inhale, last one is done on the exhale. You just throw the body down and breathe out through the mouth. It looks like this. Join me whenever you're ready. One, just stay down, allow the body to stop shaking, and then start to roll your way back up. Sweep the arms up, take hold of the opposite elbows, the arms close to the ears, pull up, bend to the right, just keep pulsing to the right, try to let the weight of the body to just drop you deeper into the bend. Without creating lots of folds in the underside of the body. And then coming back up, lengthen, go to the other side. With each pulse, try to go a little bit deeper, pull yourself a little bit more into the bend. Back to the first side. You can pulse, exhale as you pulse. Back to the center, inhale, lengthen, exhale, drop to the left. And back up. Go ahead, release the arms, and just start to swing from side to side, allow the arms to hit the body any which way. Move a little bit faster, move a little bit faster still. And then go as fast as you can. Shake it up. And then start to slow it down. Good. Wrists, loosen them up by just moving your fingers very fast from side to side. Then up and down, flapping the fingers like the wings of a hummingbird. So fast you can't even see them move. All right, so a few jumping jacks now just to warm up the heart. Slap the arms to the sides of the body and then over the head. And stop. All right, now let's come to the top of the mat. Hands together at the heart. Take a moment to just close your eyes, remembering that better than practice, even better than meditation, is to renounce all the fruits of your actions. Do the practice because it must be done as a divine, your divine duty to all beings everywhere. Let's move together as one to stay in a collective mind. Reach the arms up over the head. Come down. Don't worry about the breath. Just move the body in a way that feels intuitive to keep the breath in a steady and regular rhythm. Take the right foot back. Drop the seat down close to the heel. Take the left foot back to meet the right foot in plank. Lower down immediately. You can bring your
turn your fingers out a little bit so the elbows come into the body. As you glide forward, you might need to bring your elbows out a little bit to allow for the movement to come forward and up into cobra. Roll over the toes, back into downward facing dog. Just allow the heart to dip towards the ground. Just stay here for a moment. Bounce a little bit through the chest. Try to flatten out the arms. Think of a shape of a slide at the playground. Steep at the top and shallow at the bottom. Try to make the same shape with your body by bringing the chest and the head towards the ground. Belly towards the thighs. Good. Now lift to the hands and bring the right foot forward to the hands. It doesn't make it easily there. Lower the back knee. And then move the foot forward with the right hand if you need to. Drop the seat down low. Bring the feet back together. Uttanasana. Pull the body in towards the legs. Come all the way up to standing. Hands back to the heart. Do the poses with mindfulness and reverence. Come down, respecting every life form that you imitate. The left foot back into the deep lunge again. Lower the seat as much as you can. Come into high plank. Knees, chest, and chin down. Fingers turn out so the elbows come to the sides of the body. And then as you pull forward, elbows come up and out to the bit. Come into the cobra. Back into downward facing dog once again. Just bouncing through the heart. Bouncing a little bit, trying to get the heart close to the ground. If you're flexible, maybe you can allow the top of the head to touch and tap the ground. Or just stay there with the head resting on the ground. Pull the seat back, soften the line in the back. Then look to the hands, left foot forward. Try to move the foot forward quietly, not a big heavy thud. Lower the back knee down and the seat. Come back, feet together. Pull the body in towards the thighs. Keep your knees bent as much as you need to. Then come all the way up to standing. Hands back to the heart. Now let's try to just come into a nice regular rhythm. Come down like you're doing a dance. Right foot back into a lunge. It's a plank. Imagine you're the witness watching the body moving with grace and with ease. And then this will transpire in your practice. Come back into downward facing dog. Right foot steps forward to the hands. Remember, modify as you need to make it more comfortable and the movements more easy for you. Come all the way up. Hands back to the heart. Reach up again. Go down. Every movement, an expression of humility, of surrender. Come into high plank. Lower down. Glide through between the arms. Back into downward facing dog. Lift the seat up and back. Left foot steps forward to the hands, placing it quietly. Feet together, move in a way that doesn't disturb the witness that you're pretending to be, watching everything. Hands back to the heart. And again, go down as you pretend that you want the witness is watching. Pretend the witness is God, the highest self. So offer the best of the best that you can to the highest self. Back into downward facing dog. Right foot steps forward to the hands. Left foot joins, bow to the legs. Zone humbleness. Come up. Hands back to the heart. And again, reach up and back. Lower down gracefully. Left foot back. Into a plank. And down. Listen to the inner teacher that's guiding you through the movements. And make sure you listen to the teacher so that you don't end up in a place where you shouldn't go, in a place of pain, in a place of anxiety. And back home. And again, reach up, go down, right foot back. If you're more seasoned practitioner, you know other variations in the sun salutations. You want to go deeper, if the body feels warm, I invite you to explore your edge right foot forward, feet together, uttanasana,
and come up,
hands back home,
and up again. You have to keep on being willing to move to the edge so that you can keep on defining new levels and keep making progress down.
Glide forward and back. Imagine you're doing a dance. All of the movements link together seamlessly. And the mind, in a way that allows the mind to stay calm, unchanged, undisturbed.
A new variation this time, reach up and back.
Calm down, plant the hands. This time lift the heels, shift your weight forward. And then keep pressing your hands and your elbows and just jump back, landing about an inch away from the ground. If you want to walk back, that's fine too. And just bring the belly down, glide forward into cobra. If you feel, if you can, lift the hips away from the ground and the knees upward facing dog. Arms straight, but don't lock the joints. Keep the neck long. Make sure you don't lose your neck. Keep the neck long.
Back into Adho Mukha Savasana, downward facing dog.
Hold it for a moment, settle into the pose, pull the seat back, exhale, get soft and through the heart. Good, now getting ready to come forward, lift the heels, bend the knees, lift to the hands, jump forward to the hands, or again, if you'd rather, walk forward. Come all the way up, standing back bend, Hasta Uttanasana. Hands back to the heart.
And one more. Reach up and back.
Go down. Hands plant down from the feet. Inhale. Lift the head. Lift the heels. And jump back. Try to land lightly. And then if you can, swing forward without letting the hips touch the ground into upward facing dog. Or modify again if you need to. Back into Adho Mukha Savasana. Breathe in, pull the seat back, further breathe out. Soften again the line of the back. Soften in every sense of the word, mentally, physically, and emotionally. Then lift the heels, bend the knees.
Come forward, jumping or walking. All the way up. Hands back to the heart. Breathe in, breathe out all fatigue, all struggles, let go of all expectations and attachments to the results. Now release the arms. So now we're going to come forward, hinge forward, so you can bring your chest on your thighs, bend your knees as much as you need to keep your chest with your thighs. Slide your hands down the backs of the legs. You can step on your fingers if you let your fingers underneath with your heels. And then push the shins back into the arms. Use a body to press against the legs, so eventually the legs are straight. If you can't get your legs straight without detaching the body, keep your knees bent. And so you can move your chest further down towards the knees. If those of you who are flexible want to place your forehead against the shins, go ahead. Visualize the head coming to rest right on top of the feet. Lift the seat up a little bit more so you can feel the stretch. And then release the hands down onto the ground. Walk back into plank, lower down onto the belly. Inhale, come up halfway. Work the upper back. Keep the legs anchored down, hips firmly to the ground. And then lift your hands about an inch up off the ground. Flex the fingers, keep them active. Then place the hands down, push into the hands. You can keep your elbows bent for the first one if you like. Push the chest forward and away from the seat. Bring the head back to open up the throat again. Make sure you don't jam up your neck in between your shoulders and the ears. Roll the shoulders down, elbows come close to the body, legs together. If you're more flexible, you can walk your hands closer in towards the hips. Straighten your arms a little bit more, coming into
a little bit of a little, again, a little bit more height. The chin in, back into downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out, soften. Left foot forward between the hands, back knee down, drop the seat down nice and low, close to the front heel. Copy asana, bring the arms up, rock the shoulders back and forth a few times, up and down. Keep the elbows close to the head so the arms stay straighter, and then bring the arms back behind the ears if you can. Push the chest forward and up. Imagine the index fingers going over the back toe. If you need to stay up higher, then go where the body feels comfortable and steady. And then try to settle the mind into stillness, unchanged all throughout every experience. If you know other variations, advanced practitioners, go ahead. Some people like to bring the foot up to the head. Go ahead. Bring the hands up, chain pose. Okay. Now again, we're ready to come back up, lead at the heart, press into the front knee. Bring the body more upright, shoulders over the hips, Sukha Virabhadrasana. Shoulders down, be strong and mighty like the warrior. And keep the length as you move into Sukha Trikonasana. Left hand comes down, right arm comes up, shoulder stays with the knee. If you can, take a bind. Right arm comes behind the back, drop the shoulder a little bit, and so the left arm can come all the way through and underneath. Lock the fingers together or take hold of the right hand with your right wrist with your left hand. Pull the body against the leg. If you need to come somewhere halfway in between, just slip your hand in between the body and the thigh and press the right shoulder back. Good. From here, Parshvakonasana, lean forward to front foot, lift the back knee up, flatten out the foot. You can stay here, you can stay in your bind, or sweep the right arm over the head. You find your body's coming forward, come up higher, rest the left arm on the right, on the left thigh. Right shoulder moves back. And then start to come forward again. Turn the chest to the front, right hand down, left knee, right knee down. Inhale, come upright, move the left foot in underneath the knee. Padavita Parshvakonasana. Take the elbows to the outside of the thigh. Join hands against the heart. Left hand pushes in the right. Then the chest comes to the thumbs, and then roll the left shoulder all the way back as much as you can. Try to get the chest and the face to look right up. Imagine you're lying on your back. You want to take a bind, left arm goes over the back of the body, right arm snakes underneath, elbows in the space below, and you join the hands, pressing them against the belly. Other variations, go ahead, you can lift the back knee up. If you like, that will look like this. Push out through the heel, keep turning with the exhale. Left hip moves back and moves forward on the inhale. Another variation, if you like, just take your right hand down, left arm up over the head or over the head. Up high, I should say, or over the head. Turn the chest up again. One more breath, extend through the inhale, the side body, exhale, turn a little bit more. And then come out of the pose, right knee comes back down, Sukha Virabhadrasana. No jerky movements, nothing to distract the mind, to agitate the mind. Everything smooth, so the witness remains undisturbed. Now lizard, creep back and forth. Try and get the hips to come down lower. Move the right foot back further so the hips will drop down lower. And then rest in the pose. Right knee down, flatten up the toes. If your shoulder is lower than the knee, you can bring your right forearm down, maybe the left forearm. Eventually, you might be able to get your chest down on the ground with the knee higher than the back of the body. Keep the knee close to the shoulder by moving the left foot out a little bit if you need to, so the knee stays over the foot. Take other variations if you know them, advanced practitioners, or stay where you're comfortable. Some stay on the hands, have no judgment, just do your best. Now move your left hip back, come back onto the hands. If you're on the elbows, move into pigeon. Heel toe left foot in, rest the left thigh on the ground. The knee is a little bit on the other side of the hip or on the same line. The heels in front of the right hip. Extend the right toes back. Inhale, come up. Press your hands into the lower back onto the heels, the palms on the seat, and push the rib basket up. Elbows come behind the body. Try to make it so that you don't create any wrinkles in the back. From here, lift back up, keep the length as you move forward to prone pigeon. Left hip moves back, stay where it's suitable for you. Higher, maybe halfway down. With your fists, forehead and fists if you like, or flat out. Extend your lines, side body lengthens, spine lengthens. Up now. Right, so from here, we're going to bend the toes under on the back foot. Now you might be able to move right into Vasisthasana from here. So you plant the right hand down, push it down into the hand. So modification, if you're more new with the practice, you just slip your left foot back and come into modified side plank. Stay on your shin. If you're more apt to, you can press into your hand, lift the hips away from the ground, and come up into full side plank. Those of you who are more advanced still, you would take your shin with you. So lift up your hip, turn your foot towards the side, turn the hips and chest up. Now if you can, you can eventually reach for the foot as well. Arc the body away from the ground. Keep strong through the right arm. Make sure you're not collapsing into the shoulder. Keep the arm extended. And then return, downward facing dog. Breathe in, pull the seat back, breathe out, soften. Move the right foot between the hands, back knee down. Once again, kapyasana. Pull the arms up, and then pull the arms back, drop the shoulders down, move your shoulders if you need to again. Just visualize a pose in your mind, visualize a crescent moon. Try to make your body come into that same form that you see. Same variation as you did before. If you want to bring your foot up to the head, go ahead. Your arms would come up to the sky. Pose, leave the heart, press into the front knee, come more upright, turn to the left. Sukha Virabhadrasana. And Sukha Chikanasana, right hand down, left arm up. Open up fully to this side. Left arm moves all the way back as much as you can. Be mindful again of your limitations. Respect them. You don't want to offer pain to those. If you think of your practice as an offering, this is not what you want to offer, pain and suffering. So come to a place where you find your comfortable edge, where you feel steady and comfortable. But
but still working the body so that you're definitely, you're surely doing your best. From here, side angle. You can keep your bind if you like, just lift the back knee up away from the ground. Otherwise, you can extend your left arm up or over the head. Move the left shoulder back. Break the pose. Lower the left knee down. Inhale, come upright, left arm up. Go to the outside. Twist the body so you can get your elbow to the outside of the knee. Join the hands. If your hands are near the shoulder, keep pushing down into the hands until the body comes up over the thigh. And push the chest towards the thumbs. Center the chest towards the thumbs. Roll the right shoulder all the way back. Pull the right hip back, head forward, exhale, roll a little bit deeper. Feel free to stay on your knee or come off your knee if you like. Do other variations as you see fit. The extended pose is nice too. Right arm up or over the head. Break the pose mindfully. Left knee down. Sukha Virabhadrasana again. And then go down. Hips and shoulders facing forward. Slide your left foot back as far back as you can so the hips come close to the ground. And you just keep on sinking the hips down, feeling as though there are weights in your hip pockets. Or a big weight resting right on top of your seat. Eventually, the lower body will come down flat and the chest might fall too. Move according to your condition. Fix the gaze like a lizard. Try to imitate the form as much as possible. Once you be one with the form, that's when you find the steadiness. That's when you find the ability to quiet the mind. Getting ready to come back up. Come back onto the hands if you're on the forearms. Reposition your left leg. So the heels in front of the left hip. Resist your right leg, I think I should say. And then the thigh in line with the hip or the knee a little bit to the outside, just a little bit. Hands to the seat and just try to smooth out the wrinkles in the lower back by pressing the chest up away from the hips. Bring the elbows back. Pushing the seat down with the heels, your palms as well. Back up. Stay long as you go down. Keep the spine long. Stay again where it's suitable for you. Keep right hip, the right side of the seat grounded. Place a block or something underneath if the seat doesn't contact the earth. Push into something and then rest in the pose. With your head down, notice how this embodies a sense of surrender. Allow yourself to surrender to the pose. Then the body can rest more easily in the pose too. To come back up. Bend the toes under, take the variation that you like. So if you want to try the
the more advanced position, you have to scooch your knee and bend the toes under. Keep your hips high, body away from the ground. Spin on the base of the toes. Keep pressing into your hands. And just open up the chest in the sky. Maybe take the foot if you like, if you have the reach. Or modify again as you need to. Come back gracefully, downward facing dog. Breathe in. Breathe out, soften again, align in the back. I'll bring the forearms down onto the ground here. Options here, just lift your heels, come back down. This is for those who aren't able to move the feet closer. If you can, move them as close as possible to the elbows. And then press up again, off the heels, right onto your tippy toes and back down. I like to lift one leg as well, so you can take your left leg behind your head, flex the foot, keep the knee bent very deeply so it's close to the body. Push into the arms, you might get a little bit of buoyancy. If you keep pressing your knee into the belly and push into your forearms, you might be able to come up eventually. Don't go fast, don't go hard. Control it. Hover there if you like, if you can. And back down. Come into child's pose for a moment. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now take a moment to just imagine yourself coming into the pose effortlessly. Whatever one, whatever variation you like. And try again. Come into forearm table, shoulders over the elbows, lift the seat. If you like, you can raise the other leg up, see how that goes for you. Sometimes it's easier, sometimes it's not as natural. Just try to all experiences. This goes for just off the mat as well. Just be willing to just enter into new experiences, okay? Push into your elbows. Keep your knees bent, like I said, to keep your body close to the ground. If you do fall over, you're close to the ground. It's not as big of an impact. Okay. And back down into child's pose. Breathe in. Breathe out. And then roll your way up. Let's come back into downward facing dog. Breathe in. Soften through the heart. You can either jump your feet forward or walk your feet forward. Utkatasana. Lower the seat. Bring the seat back. Arms in front. And peel your belly up off the thighs. Look up between the hands. An expression of devotion and surrender. Stay strong and engaged. Body's working hard, the mind is completely unaffected, undisturbed. Reach up a little bit higher. Come all the way up. Good, bring the hands back to the heart. Breathe in. Breathe out. All fatigue. Release the arms now. I'm going to try a balanced pose. Okay, let's try dancer. Lots of different variations here. We're standing on your left foot first. So we anchor down through the left foot, press the edge of the feet, the toe pads, the heel down. Lift the right knee up so you can take hold of the ankle more easily. Raise the left arm up for balance. And then you can either stay here and stay straight up. Or you can tilt forward, soften the standing leg if you need to. Push the foot back into your hand. Try to get the foot at the height of the head, thigh level to the ground. Other variations, if you're very flexible, you can see if you can take hold closer to the knee and see if you can straighten the leg more. Come down a little bit lower so the body is flat.
Bring the arm down. Breathe in. Breathe out. Whatever happened in the pose, be unconcerned. Let go of any negative emotions that rose up or thoughts. Try again on the other foot. When you're ready, build the pose. Just picture yourself in a pose, holding it effortlessly and steadily. And then move into the pose. Whatever happens, be unconcerned and unjudging. Do your best. So again, you can stay upright if you like. Or cant the body. Okay. If you're very flexible, those of you who are dancers, you can take hold of the foot. This is a nice variation too. Take hold of the outside of the foot, thumb in the base of the toes. Bring the left elbow out to the side and make sure the elbow is over the shoulder at all times, higher than the shoulder. And you can come into this variation. Okay, these are just different expressions, different forms. I should have mentioned that, you know, maybe try to do the same form as you did on the other side. So, okay. Hold it for another 15 seconds. Stay strong and determined in the pose. Offer it up and it becomes better than the best. Think of the divine self. Imagine you're doing in front of the divine self of God, in front of God. And come down. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now we're going to make our way down. We'll stand at the top of the mat. Bring the arms out in front, lower down at a constant rate. Keep your shoulders back. Try to keep your back straight like you're sliding down a wall. Keep your feet separated a little bit. Tuck the tail. Make your way down. Stay firm. Through the seat, through the core, try not to move forward. Bring the seat close to the ground, touch it down lightly, continue to move your way down, try not to fall down heavily. Extend your arms and legs, breathe in, exhale, remove all fatigue. Imagine you're fainting, just drop it all out of the body. Coming back to seated position, any which way you like, roll onto the side or just sit straight up. Maybe I'll do it this way as you can see. Left leg is extended, right foot up, and then just move the leg out to the side and back and forth. Or circle. That's anything to loosen the joints a little bit, the hip joints. And I like to also push the knee behind the body, underneath the arm. Good. Now from here, lean back so the shoulder comes against the knee. And then when the foot comes down, it might come right down on top of the thigh. If it comes down, if you know you can do your lotus easily, without straining your knee, you just tuck the heel into the hip crease, the toes come up high on the leg. And then on the hip, and then knee comes down. If you have something, if the knee's floating up, not quite to the ground, place under something underneath the knee, or hold the foot with, hold the knee with your left hand. Otherwise, if your knee is way high, it's not doable, you just place your foot on the ground, the heel in front of the seat, the base, ball of foot pressing into the inner thigh. So go into a twist here, move to the right, the chest over the right knee. Right arm circles around. If you have your foot on your thigh, you might be able to take hold of the foot. Even if it's on the ground, some of you might have long arms and you can take hold of the toes. Left hand, press the back of the fist against the right knee. Inhale, push the lower back in. Exhale, twist to the right. Twist from the hips. And feel the twist move all the way up through the back of the body. Right up until the chin turns with the shoulder. Chest stays open. Keep the back straight. Try not to to round the back. And then coming back to face forward here. All right, so we're going to try a little variation first before we go into the other side. Bring the left knee up and bring the right foot across the thigh. Now push into your hands and then come up right. Move forward until you're sitting, you're resting on the base of the toes and you're sitting on your heel. So you can either stay here, or if it's too much, you can extend your leg forward. Okay, try to squeeze your thighs together. And you can just stay upright. You can even try to see if you can release your right hand, maybe your left hand as well. Push into the roots of the toes. And down. Bring your seat back down. And then the other side, bring the right leg out, take hold of the left foot, and move it around again, back and forth. Any which way you like to loosen the hip joint. Push the knee behind the body. When you're coming to lotus, you lean back so the heel, when it lands, comes very close to where it needs to be. So you can just slip your foot in more easily. Try to get the foot as high in the hip crease as possible. Take your modification as you need to, then twist the body so the chest is over the left knee. Left arm comes around. Use the other hand to assist the hand forward to find the foot. If you're more flexible, try to take hold the ankle. And then right hand to the outside of the left knee. Back of the fist pressing into the outside of the knee. Lift up through the chest. Turn with the exhale. Make sure your right leg is not getting lazy. Keep it active. Toes and the knees are pointing up. Keep extending to the heel and the base of the big toe. And moving back. Again, slide your right heel in. Move your foot out a little bit if it's in lotus. Walk forward until you can sit on your heel and you're on the balancing on the base of the toes. You can stay here, stay upright, and see if you can take your hands up off the ground. Try, find it helpful to push the heel towards one side of the seat against the sit bone, as opposed to trying to place it right in the middle. Okay, just sort of keep the fingertips on the ground, all good. And release. Shake out the legs. Inversions. Shil Shasana, king of the postures. If you're very new with the pose, you can just do a few different things. If you're very uncomfortable to come really high off the ground, keep your forehead close to the knees and just lift your seat. Your seat is over, your upper back is pressing forward like a wall. And you push the belly button. And so you're trying to push it up through the lower back. Keep holding on to the heels. Wise, take your forearms forward. If you can take all the elbows, it's about the right distance. It should be the width of the shoulders. Interlace the fingers. Place the forehead in front of the hands. And then lift up. Walk your feet towards the elbows. Lift one leg up, just as we did before in the forearm balance. And then just see if you can just press up off the heel. Push into the forearms, really press into the forearms, and push the belly, the thigh or the knee into the belly if you can. If you have
Have your knee foot closer to the elbows, a little bit more doable. Keep your legs close to the body so that you stay, it's easier to balance when your body's compact. Okay, if you're very comfortable in the pose, go ahead into your variations, those of you who are proficient at headstands. And just stay. Remember, keep activating the feet by pressing up through the base of the toes, bend your toes back. Let's remind you to keep everything engaged that you need to stay balanced. And do this against the wall if you need to. This foot behind you would come against the wall. Just play off the wall. Down slowly and rest in child's pose. Breathe in, breathe out all fatigue. All right, next thing that we're going to try, those of you who have trouble with forearm balance, sometimes it's easier to come from headstand. Again, these are all options. You can always do one of the ones that we did before for headstand, okay? So, but keep repeating, eventually you become comfortable. So you just have to keep on trying. All right, so if you're doing, want to try coming to forearm balance, I find it easier to keep my hands not interlacing the head and press the, just the base, the wrist against the, just at the top of the forehead on each side of the forehead. And then lift up again. I find it easiest to split my legs, keeping your legs close to the body. And then you want to do like you're doing a cobra action. You push into the arms, make sure you push through the back foot, the foot that's behind you, a little bit more. And then you just lift your head forward, tilt your head forward, so you're looking forward. You lift your chin. That's all you have to do. Look beyond your fingertips. Okay, or you can just press into forearms and lift straight up the head from the ground. So you're looking behind at this, in front of you. Okay, so either way, either just tilt your head forward, might be easier to balance, or just straight up. Coming back down, gently. Breathe in, breathe out. And don't fight the mind too much. If the mind's not ready, it's constantly screaming, you just stop, because it's, then just go with that. Just keep on visualizing yourself in a pose. One day, perhaps a body, you'll feel convinced and wanting to do it. So just wait for that opportunity. No need to force it. Roll your way up, find your way onto your back. Lie down, breathe in, exhale, imagine you're fainting, let go of all fatigue. Now bring your arms close to the body, on either side of the body, palms down, raise your legs up, keep pushing into your arms, you can lift your seat up, oops, and then lower down again, try not to land the seat heavily, and then again, lift up a little bit higher. Press in the arms to bring your seat down lightly so it doesn't make a sound. One more time. Lift up. Most of the back is up off the mat. If it's comfortable, you can sustain it. Bring your hands to the back. Try to scoot your elbows closer in to one another behind the back. And try to find a straight line from the chin to all the way up to the toes. If you have a lotus, you may go ahead. You might need to bring your legs a little bit over your head first and use your hands, if you need to place your feet into the position. Otherwise, if you can't do a full lotus, just keep your legs straight. Either case, legs straight or lotus, you can take your hands onto your thighs as well. Then your knees have to go a little bit beyond your head, your feet, or your feet.
Now keep your mind still. Concentrate on one point of focus by bringing your attention to the space between the eyebrows. Watch the area behind the forehead, the darkness there. Leave the body alone. Eventually, you aim to get the same sensation of steadiness and comfort in every pose. You can meditate in every pose to make the pose the best that it can be, the best offering possible. If you have a lotus, come into Pindasta embryo pose. Just bring your legs against the body. If you have the ability, you can wrap your arms around the legs or Halasana. Just bring your feet down on the ground behind the head. Arms behind your back if your feet touch all the way down. Otherwise, keep supporting your back. Or drop your thighs against the body and the knees on either side of the head if you can. Withdraw from your senses. To come out now. Arms behind the body, pressing into the ground, and then lower down bit by bit. Legs stay close to the body.
Keep moving it down at an even rate. Again, no jerky movements, no fast, hard landings. Once you're down, breathe in. Breathe out. Fish pose. Bring the elbows close to the body. Hug the sides by the elbows, fingers facing up. And push into the elbows. Lift the chest and bring the top of the head back. Good. Now some people like to just slide your hands underneath the seat. That's okay too. Move your elbows in a little bit if you're doing this variation. Okay, so you can do this variation too. If you have your hands beside, fingers facing up, if you want, you can release your hands in front of your legs and bring your legs up at the same angle as the arms, so about 45 degrees. Flying fish. Now breathe very fast, like you're panting like a puppy. Do it through the nose. In, breathe out, forward by Dhanurasana. Move the feet in close to the seat, edge the feet in line with the hips, bring the fingertips on either side of the head. If you're very limited in the shoulders, just keep working at just getting your elbows as far back as you can, up towards the ceiling, then back behind your head. If you feel comfortable, do so, lift the seat. Push in the fingertips and drag your head back. Turn your hands around at this point, fingers facing a little bit outwards, and the fingers facing towards the toes, the feet. And then if you can, lift your head up off the ground. Lift the heels if you like, rock back and forth. Try to form a uniform arc from the heels of the palms all the way to the heels of the feet. If you know other variations, advanced practitioners, again, go ahead. Jump from one side to the other if you like. Do your drop backs. Lift one leg, lift one arm, then do the other side. Otherwise, stay in the pose. You can lower your heels down at any point if you like. Walk your hands towards the feet to try to get your legs and your arms straighter.
surrender to the pose so you can remain, find steadiness. Eventually, you can stay in the pose longer. And then make way to come out. Walk your hands back out a little bit. If you need to, lower down. Relax, breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale again. Imagine light and energy pouring into the body, through the pores. Exhale, let it go everywhere. Feel recharged and rejuvenated. Right. So we're going to come to seated now. Any which way you like. Start by bringing the knees up towards the chest. Balance on the sit bones. Take hold of your two piece fingers around the big toes. Try to keep your back straight and vertical. Your heels could be on the same line as the knees or straight up. Pull the shoulders back. If it's too hard to bind, you can just do normal boat. So with your legs, or your arms can keep holding onto your legs if you like, or stretched out. Bend your knees again if you need to. Now stay upright, breathe very fast. Lower the heels down, slide forward until your belly comes onto the thighs. You can hug your legs to your body. Concentrate on the base of the spine as you try to pull your body further forward so the chest goes seemingly beyond the knees. Exhale, pour more weight into legs, gradually if you like, or if you can, you know you can, extend your legs, keep your body with your legs. Keep on visualizing the spine lengthening. Be mindful, of course, of your limitations. If you have any back issues, approach everything with caution. Body is a vehicle to exercise your mission of just spreading love and compassion so the body feels broken. You don't have any enthusiasm to do this. So be mindful of everything you do. Practice mindfulness and reverence for the form that you've been given. Slowly make your way back up. Bend your knees, slide your feet in a little bit, and slip your arms underneath the legs. Hold the outer edge of the feet. Lock your seat back, and you can bring your head down on the ground or close to the ground as you can get it. Create fullness in the back of the body by imagining trying to push the belly button right through the lower back. If you know Kirmasana, keep your knees close to the shoulders, move the knees close in, raise them up a little bit higher, bring your arms close to the hips, and then you can maybe slide your feet out in front. The weight of the legs on the arms allows your body to come down further. Again, the tension is always at the base of the spine. If you can wrap your arms around the back of the body and join your hands over the back, you're welcome to do that variation. More breath. Slowly come out. Come up. And then press into your feet, come up into a little bit of a half squat. Right, so you're going to try to get your left shoulder right close to the left knee.
Bring the left arm underneath and the right arm over the back. Take hold of the fingers or take hold of the right wrist and left hand. Raise the right side of the seat up. If you want to go into bird of paradise, right from here you can. You step your right foot in a little bit to the left. And you do this in one smooth motion. You press the arm into the leg and you come up, press into the foot. You come up. If you can, you can extend your leg. Okay. Move it back behind the shoulder as much as you can. Down, bend the knee, heavy on the right foot, lower down, gradually. Just hang out right down for a moment, extend first and exhale. No violent, fast, aggressive movements, okay? Just relax, soften. When you're ready, go to the other side. Again, bring the shoulder down low, so shoulders against the knee, the right arm comes underneath the leg. Left arm over the back. Take hold of the fingers and the finger lock or hold the left wrist up. Left wrist with your right hand and lift the left side of the seat. Eventually try to get your right leg straight as well. Head's close to the ground. Feel free to stay here or come into your bird of paradise. Walk your right foot in, press into your left foot and don't think too much about it. Imagine yourself moving gracefully. Keep watching the body moving. You're always a witness. Move the leg back behind the shoulder as much as you can. Turn, pull the leg, press heavy into the foot, left standing foot, and release. Then right down, breathe in, breathe out. Good. All right, bring your knees back. Child's pose. Inhale. Slide forward onto the belly. Start off with Sphinx pose. Push the forearms into the ground. Pull the chest forward, shoulders back. Anchor down through the lower body. Now if you like, lift your elbows up off the mat. Curve the spine a little bit more, bring the head towards the seat. Move your hands closer. As you see fit, come up higher. Move the legs together. Let it come sometimes onto the fingertips. Get a little bit more height. Lower down slowly, mindfully. And come down. Breathe in. Breathe out. Last back bend, take hold of the ankles. Try to keep the feet free. Lift up the chest, push the ankles into the hands. Keep the thighs on the ground. Try to get as much height through the chest as possible. Then if you feel comfortable, tug on the legs a little bit. Try to pull on the feet so they come higher than the head. Straighten out the arms. Try not to allow your feet to go way out to the side. Keep them about hip width apart. Try to get as much of the body up off the ground, upper body off the ground as well. Keep breathing, do not hold the breath. Come out, pull the feet closer to the seat, come down. Breathe in. Breathe out, relax.
underneath the underneath the shoulders. Make your way up, sit upright, bring your legs out in front. Let's go. Final seated twist. Ardha Matsyendrasana. You can fold the left leg in, knee in front of the body, foot on the other side of the right side of the hip, and then the left foot over, the right foot over on the other side. Otherwise, you can keep the left leg straight if your hips don't, both hip bones don't, can't plant down equally. And you bring your foot between the knee and the ankle. I'll just do this version first. You can stay with me if this is where you feel like you're at. Right hand right against the back, behind the center of the seat. Left arm up. Press the forearm against the thigh and turn the body to the right as much as you can. Pull the knee beyond the left edge of the body, more towards the left. If you want, you take your Ardha Matsyendrasana, the full pose. You can do a few different things here. You can take hold of, keep your shoulder against the knee. You can either hold the heel in front, left heel in front, or if you have more reach, take hold the inner edge of the foot. Right hand can come around. You can try to get your hand to press into your left hip crease as well. Chest open, make sure the back is straight as can be. Very detoxifying poses, twists. Imagine you're bringing all the toxins out of the body. And slowly release. Other side. And take the modification that's more suitable. Make sure both sides of the seat are grounded. Sometimes the left side of the seat rides up. Push the left side of the seat down. Right arm up. And go into the pose again. Take whatever variation you like. Hold the heel in front. As you push against the inner knee. Or take hold of the foot. Or you can do it. So the inner edge of the foot. Left hand comes around. So you can press the hand into the hip crease. If it doesn't reach, just keep your hand just behind the seat. Center the seat. Your shoulders level if you can. Try not to lift the shoulders, but raise the upper back, the lower back. Break the pose. Lie on your back for Shavasana. Ease your way down. No jerky motions or hard, aggressive landings again. And then rest the body. Just allow the feet to fall away from one another, the arms. Resting on either side of the mat, the palms facing up. And just surrender to complete relaxation. Deep relaxation is the best antidote for removing impurities. Just take your attention to the right hand. Loosen up all the fingers. Allow them to go limp. The back of the hand resting heavily. This palm soft. The wrist joint. Just allow the whole arm to relax, to go limp and heavy, right up to the shoulder. Then the left arm, the same thing. Relax the fingers, relax the wrists. And feel the heaviness just creep up the arm, releasing the elbow and the shoulder joint as well. Everything feels dead-like.
through the back of the body, from the shoulders all the way down to the hips. Just sink the torso into the ground, melt, with the shoulder blades just becoming heavy. The lungs, everything in the trunk of the body, relaxing. Then the right leg from the hip, the seat, the hip joint relaxes and loosens. And the right thigh feeling heavy like lead. Feel the heaviness just move further down the leg, all the way to the ankle, to the foot as well. Heel heavy on the ground, no tightness, no tension. Foot is soft, the toes are limp. Left side, the seat as well now. The hip joint, starting at the hips, feeling that heaviness just in, come further, absorbing into the body, the left thigh, heavy. Left knee, loose, inactive, the lower leg, foot, everything completely relaxed. The head heavy as well. All the muscles of the face relaxed. No tightness in the jaw. No strain showing in the forehead. Relax and soften the forehead. Relax the jaw, the tongue, everything. Feel as lifeless as a corpse. And that way you become even more receptive to receiving all the gifts of the practice. Imagine it coming in, the best of the best occurring right now, through absorption of the love, the goodness, all the gifts of all the other yogis practicing alongside with you. Absorb it all with gratitude. Send it right to the residing place of the divine spark that resides within, as I say, God, residing in the spiritual heart in the center of the chest, to the right side of the physical heart. slowly start to bring your attention back to the physical form as your own. Reconnect with the body, feel it starting to awaken. Feeling the fingers and the toes, feeling the breath again. The arms, the legs, move them a little bit so as to acknowledge them, their existence. And with the utmost mindfulness, quietness, and reverence, prepare to sit up. Do so in a way that allows you to preserve all the serenity that we created through the practice. Once you're seated, be tall and still and supreme. We're going to do some pranayama now. Surya Kumbhaka Chandra Pranayama, alternate nostril breathing with breath retention. So during the we're starting on the active side, so we'll do that momentarily, but to go over the hand position, left hand, index finger and thumb joined together, other three fingers extended, resting on the left knee. The right hand is used to control the passage of the breath through the second channels of the left side and the right side of the nose, through the nostrils. Second, third fingers fold down, right thumb to close off and to open the right nostril, the right ring finger to close off and to open up the left nostril. Okay. So to find the active nostril, you just close off one side, send a few puffs of breath through, just try to figure out which one feels more open to you. That is your active side. If they feel exactly the same, just default to the left side as your active side. So we're going to inhale through for a count of four, inhale as much as you can. Hold the breath. During breath retention, you're contracting the perineum muscles, pull them up towards the navel. So pull it right up. And feel the tension there. And then bring the chest up high, chin on the chest, tongue to the upper palate, just behind the teeth. And the attention is at the third eye. That's during the breath retention for a count of 16. Exhale for a count of 8. Release the locks. Allow the breath to pass through. Inhale back through the active side. Holding a breath again, breath of tension, both sides of the nose closed, exhale through the less active side. Okay. So we're starting on the active side and ending on an active side for a full cycle. So let's begin, sitting up tall and straight. Breathe in through both nostrils. Empty the lungs, exhale. Close off the less active side. Inhale through the active, 2, 3, 4. Hold the breath, plug both sides of the nose, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Breathe out through the less active. Release the locks. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Breathe in through the less active. 2, 3, 4. Hold the breath. Apply the throat in a root lock. Third eye focus. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Release. Out through the active side, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale right away, active. 4, hold the breath, retain the breath, all the attention at the third eye. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Breathe out through the less active side, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale through the less active. Hold in the breath. Apply the locks. Third eye focus. Keep the face calm. No tension showing in your face. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Breathe out through the active. 2, 3, 4, six, seven, eight. Inhale, the active. Holding for a count to 16. Exhale through the less active. Release the locks. Make sure it's a steady exhale. Stream out, stream the breath out. Inhale, stream in. It's nice and even. Then hold it. Retain the breath. Find your focus at the space between the eyebrows. Exhale through the active side. Continue on your own for a few more cycles. Very good for calming the mind, bringing it to a quiet place as needed for meditation. Keep the spine ever straight. Next time you exhale through the active side, conclude. Done, the right hand comes back in Yana Mudra as well, resting on the right knee. Restraighten, close the eyes or just gaze beyond the tip of the nose, your eyes ever so slightly open. Continue to be the witness, watching all the thoughts, the mind activity without any judgment. Any attempt to process what's happening in the mind. Watch the emotions without any judgment, any concern. Remain unperturbed so that when you go into your daily life and through your experiences, you also remain calm, unaffected. Is happening exactly the way it should be, according to our conditions. Accept what comes along with gratitude for every experience. Brings us a little bit more knowledge and helps us to break the patterns that cause pain and suffering. Imagine your heart going ever greater in compassion to reach all beings. For when compassion drives all your actions, thoughts, and words, you set yourself up for positive experiences that keeps you in a place that's content, that's free of strife, of pain. Suffering. close with Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Instill the peace within, send it out to all beings everywhere. Receptive to the divine grace within. Namaste. Thank you very much for joining.